conversation with her.
Okay. How's this? Your client viciously stabbed a young mother, then took the body and her breathing 14-month-old toddler from the apartment and buried the boy alive. I'm itching to put a needle in his veins, but I'll settle for life. No parole.
What a moving speech. Too bad no one will get to hear it. I'm the Bruce Casey.
In limine, motion to suppress, motion to dismiss.
Okay, counsel. You've got 2 minutes.
My client's Fifth and Sixth Amendment rights were violated. The police interrogated him without counsel.
Did he ask for one?
No. Darius Parker was read his rights, and then he signed a Miranda card.
Sounds pretty straightforward to me.
He told police he had an open case. I'm the attorney of record that conveniently neglected to call me.
Because no one had to. Texas versus Cobb, Your Honor. The Supreme Court ruled that suspects could be questioned on other charges regardless of representation.
In Cobb, the defendant admitted he burglarized the murder victim's home. No linkage, no case.
Walker.
Darius Parker never asked for an attorney.
Will you stipulate he informed police he had an outstanding burglary charge and a court date?
Yes.
Then my client didn't need to invoke. The right was implied. The police should have stopped the interrogation and waited. It will cost him nothing but time.
I have to agree with Mr. Horowitz on this one.
But, Your Honor,
the police knew the defendant had counsel, and they ignored it. There's been a lot of that going around lately, and that disturbs me. The confession's out, and so are any fruits born from it.